So, you probably all know that a few days ago, on December 2nd, Jupiter entered into Capricorn, which for a slow-moving planet like Jupiter is quite a big shift because it only changes signs every year. So, for the last year, it's been in Sagittarius, which is its home sign, and now it went into Capricorn. So, we all might feel this shift of energy going on. It will stay in Capricorn until December 2020, so a pretty long process and a lot of Capricornian energy because it's not only Jupiter in Capricorn, there's also Saturn and Pluto. So we're gonna have a full-on Capricorn year. But let's stick with Jupiter for now. So Jupiter tends to blow up and really make bigger everything that he touches. So with Jupiter in Capricorn, we're gonna have a year where we will feel like we want to strip away everything from our lives that is just not the very bare minimum we need. Because Capricornian energy wants us to focus only on what's really important and to have a serious look on our life. And with Jupiter blowing up this energy, we will find ourselves mucking out our life and all the junk that we accumulated through Jupiter in Sagittarius. So not only physically, but also emotionally. Some people might start this period with cleaning out their houses or quitting too much social contact in order to focus on what's really important, or a diet, or maybe cleaning out some people from their life, ending a relationship, whatever it is. But there will definitely be the need to size down on many levels. The past year with Jupiter in Sagittarius was all about expansion because, Sagittarius is about like just reaching out in all directions and getting new information and new experiences that we haven't had before. And Capricorn, on the other side, is about focusing on one thing, on what's really important. So while with Jupiter and Sag, we expanded and we grabbed for as much new input as we can get, now we feel like looking at all the stuff that we gathered and deciding what's really worth keeping. Which friends, which job, which partner, which habits, which mindsets. So, for those people who naturally have Capricornian qualities in their chart, this influence will really boost their ambition and drive to achieve more and to step up their game in life. For those who are naturally leaning more towards a relaxed, from day to day lifestyle, this can be a challenging period. Because this energy is going to make them feel very pressured because it demands us to take action, to make decisions, long-term decisions. And people who are not used to that, they might in the first moment try to escape this energy, try to, go into fun or reality escapes of some sort, whatever, drugs, alcohol, video games. But the more they escape it, the higher the pressure will become until it actually starts consuming all of their escape mechanisms. Meaning, they will not be able to enjoy going out anymore because they will still, even then, feel worried and be thinking about the decisions that they are avoiding. Or they might just simply be taken down by a physical, illness and might not be able to have fun, but actually might need to focus. So, yeah, this is a year where we need to deal with our stuff. We need to. Now, when we mix this influence with Uranus and Taurus, we can see that it can be an economical and financial boost this year for those who have innovative ideas about money or security, because Taurus is obviously about the material world and about security. And Uranus in Taurus, because Uranus is the inventor, the genius, the revolutionary, Uranus in Taurus wants us to reinvent the financial sector and the material sector and the way we find security in our lives. So, with the combination of those two influences, many who focus their energy onto some innovative technology for the financial sector, for improving society structures, or for environmental topics, they might truly succeed in this year. We might see a lot of startups that are offering revolutionary ways of dealing with security, maybe new ways of social insurance. There is already so many kind of new bank alternatives popping up. There is a lot of companies, like independent startup companies popping up that offer new health insurance solutions, which are much cheaper and much more improved than the standardized ones. Then there is, for example, apps that can help you make money with cryptocurrencies. And not to forget, of course, blockchain technology, which, just can influence all sectors of commerce and economy and lead to more trust and transparency. So yeah, these are the kinds of inventions that will have a high success rate this year, most probably. But when I talk about ambitions and success, you know, everybody immediately switches to job and to career. But Jupiter in Capricorn is not only about job and career. You know, this can mean that you will take on something that you've been wanting to take on for a long time, but you just didn't have the discipline for. It can be any goal you have. It doesn't need to have anything to do really with the job. It can be, you know, losing those 10 pounds or finally learning how to paint or doing a driving license or succeeding in a relationship, for example. Most of the things you wanted, but you have been putting off. Now is the turn, you know, now the turn has come. So if you finally take it on, in this year, Jupiter really might give you, you know, the necessary push, the necessary patience and determination to finally carry through on those things. Since Capricornian energy is very much concerned with building a future and with, you know, stability, this is a time of laying foundations. So doing the things that you need to do in order to achieve your long-term goals, like putting down the building blocks for your future, doing things that maybe are not the most fun to do, but certainly the most sensible in the long run. And it is also time to face your obstacles, because Capricorn is also about our limitations. So we might become more aware of our limitations and our obstacles in life and our boundaries maybe as well in this year. And is it time to look at them, to confront them and maybe overcome them, or just learn to live with them and respect them as well? You know, Jupiter in Capricorn will help you and demand of you to put in the work to develop skills and discipline that will make your achievements of your big goals possible. And facing your limitations is also part of that. So this year, you want to take decisions that are a short-term sacrifice, but a long-term, you know, contribution to your goal. You want to maybe like start building more on your professional skills, or taking another step to become an expert in what you're already doing, or thinking about further education, or changing to a job with better advancement opportunities, and so on. You know, this is a year really of thinking how you can become more expert, more proficient in whatever you're doing, how you can step up your game. And last but not least, Capricornian energy is also very much connected to the father, like the father energy. So this year, no matter if consciously or unconsciously, this will exaggerate your dad's voice in your head. Everything that dad used to tell you is really strongly present in your mind now. And, you know, depending on how your relationship with your father was, if it was rather like a competitive one or a harmonious one, you know, this can play out in different ways. It can, you know, can reiterate voices of your father telling you how you're not good enough, you're not gonna make it, and so on, and you know, igniting a desire in you to prove him wrong. Or it can be a memory, you know, of things your father used to tell you, advices that maybe in the time you didn't understand, but now they finally sink in and you're like, oh my god, dad was actually right about things. So this is something that Jupiter in Capricorn can also do for you. Now, of course, in every chart, Jupiter in Capricorn will fall into a different house. So in which area this specifically plays out for you, that can be very individual. But whatever house it falls into, this is going to be the house that you feel the need to step up in. For example, if it's in the seventh house, you might feel like, okay, this relationship needs to go a step further, maybe marriage, maybe children, maybe moving together. Or in the fifth house, you might want to make your hobby a career, or you just might want to get much more proficient in your hobby. If you've been painting for years, maybe now you want to, you know, take a step and become a really, really good painter. Or since the fifth house is also connected to children, there might be a manifestation, because Capricorn energy is also about the material world, and the manifestation can be the manifestation of a child as well. In the second house, it might ignite some, you know, strong desire to finally manifest some serious long-term income source and financial stability, and so on. All in all, you know, you can say that Cap brings a lot of, it brings the energy down, right, a little bit from the Sagittarian excited optimistic energy, but it will bring a lot of clarity. Clarity through pragmatism, you know, through striping off all the unnecessary and letting us focus on what's important only. Now, how will this differ from the energy last year? Last year, Jupiter in Sagittarius, like I said, was all about exploring new areas, expanding, trying new things. And Capricorn is all about getting back to the old, back to the roots, to what we know, you know, security, sustainability. Again, like, for example, how this might play out in the houses is, if you had this transit of Jupiter in Sagittarius in the fourth house, it might mean that in the Sag season, while Jupiter was in Sag, you were traveling around a lot, exploring different countries, searching for your home, considering, you know, taking in all the input of how it feels to be in different environments and where you might want to live. And then when Jupiter comes in Cap and is still in your fourth house, it might suddenly feel like, you know, maybe I want to move back to where I come from for a while and, you know, connect back with my roots. Or maybe I just want to, you know, settle down and build a really stable foundation. I don't really feel like exploring anymore. All right. For example, in the 10th house, it could be that while Jupiter was in Sag, you were just entertaining a lot of thoughts of changing jobs and looking for something that might give you more excitement or more freedom. And then suddenly Cap comes and you're like, but wait a second, actually, that doesn't make any sense. I should just rather invest my energy into becoming better in what I am already doing and what I've already been doing, instead of just starting from scratch somewhere else. Right? So this is kind of what this switch in energy might do to you. You know, Sagittarius and Capricorn, ruled by Jupiter and Saturn, also have this energy of, you know, good teacher, bad teacher, because they're both representing a teacher, like Saturn and Jupiter. Jupiter is the good teacher, you know, the one that inspires you, the one that gives you input and doesn't give you any rules, but, you know, gives you a lot of inspiration and motivates you. And Saturn is the teacher who gives you rules and wants you to do your work and wants you to prove yourself. So, you know, in the last year we were learning with Jupiter in Sagittarius, so inspiration. This year we're learning with Jupiter in Capricorn, so it's going to be rules and structure and demanding stuff of us. And if we follow the rules, we're going to get a great grade. But if we don't, then we're just gonna probably be punished. Yeah, Saturn ultimately wants duty, dedication, discipline, and mastery from us. It's not anymore about enjoying, about recklessness, about throwing ourselves head over heels into new experiences. It's about wisdom, taking things slowly and thoroughly, and moving on. So, you know, throughout this period of Jupiter and Sag, we accumulated a lot of inspiration, a lot of soul wisdom, that can help us now to know what we want to focus on in the Capricorn season. The downside of Jupiter and Sag is that it can make us a little bit lazy. You know, we don't take things seriously, we're optimistic, and now suddenly the bomb, you know, falls in and we're like, oh shoot, I do need to make some serious decisions here. So that might be the feeling when this energy switch comes. So there's obviously also a downside to Capricorn, because Jupiter blows things up, so it can blow it up too much as well. And since Capricorn is the opposite sign of Cancer, and Cancer is all about our emotions, our needs, you know, our inner world, Capricorn just, you know, takes us away from that and makes us forget about our emotions. So we might have less concern about our needs and our health, and we might stretch beyond our limits to reach our goal. So we want to really pay some caution here. And since Capricorn is also, you know, about competition and success and wealth, this transit can blow up our greed and our tendency to go to extremes and hunger for success and for material wealth so much that we forget what's truly important in life, which is our emotional connections, our friends, our family, all Cancer, and our humanity. So, you know, we want to follow our goals, but we still want to stay connected with ourselves and with the people we love. So I guess that's my last thought on the next year, my last advice. And stick in there, guys. I hope you achieve a lot. And let me know what your experience with Jupiter in Capricorn is in the comments. Really looking forward to it.